Curtis was certainly known to bring people together in life, and his passing is now doing the same. News Center 5's Phil Lipoff has the tributes that are coming in from very familiar faces, Phil.
Heather, a giant in our business, but Chet Curtis was so much more than just that. He was a husband, a father, a friend, a mentor, and he touched so many lives.
No one could bring people together quite like Chet could, whether you were gathered around a TV as he delivered the news.
All day today I was going around Boston and walking around at work and so on, and people would come up to me like it was a member of my family, and they'd say, "I'm so sorry you lost your friend." And that's, I mean, I felt like all of Boston was mourning him today.
Or you were lucky enough to hear one of his jokes.
Dick, you know, I'm in the twilight of a mediocre career.
Nothing mediocre about Chet, though. He was always authentic. Tonight, our newsroom felt less like a workspace and more like a local gathering spot. Mary Richardson and Dick Albert, just a few of the familiar faces coming back to share their stories of the man, not just the anchor man.
I don't know what it is about Chet and the everybody trusted what he said and just wanted to listen to what he said.
Competitors respected him just as much as those of us who work here.
Chet was Chet. I mean, he was the same if you sat down with him for a cup of coffee or a beer, or if you watched him on the air. That was the same guy.
Live from Boston.
So many lives touched, especially during the years Chet and Natalie hosted the Jerry Lewis MDA Labor Day Telethon, always one of the most successful nationally, raising almost $50 million. Nick Johnson met Chet there.
The world is truly a better place for Chet being in it. Period.
And Chet gave so many of us advice when we were getting into the business. He told me almost 20 years ago, be a good storyteller, because the best anchors are the best reporters. And Chet was the best of both.